So this video is gonna be really special because I'm about to review the Oxygen OS 15, but not on a OnePlus phone. I'm gonna be reviewing it on this Poco phone. Yes, you heard me right, this Poco X4 Pro. And you might be thinking that how is it even possible? Well, have you heard of port rooms? If you don't, just simply Google it.
Huh?
Anyways, in simple words, porting ROM means to make a ROM of a specific device compatible to work on another device. So in this case, this Oxygen OS 15 has been ported from the OnePlus 13. So not only you get the Oxygen OS running on the Poco X4 Pro, but also the latest features from the flagship. So I'll be discussing everything starting from the system UI, the features, the performance, and obviously the bugs you need to know before flashing it. So without wasting any further time, let's start the video. And if you are new to the channel, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button right now, because only 4% of the people watching my videos have subscribed. So make sure to sub right now or you are getting touched by this woman. So starting with the settings UI, so on first glance you get this type of colorful icons for every other settings, and the UI looks really clean. I mean, typical Oxygen OS vibe. Anyways, moving down to the about phone section, you can check the model name on the top saying Redmi Note 11 E Pro, which is another name for the Poco X4 Pro, but anyways, it clearly states the version as Oxygen OS 15. And by the way, the shout out goes to Simple Boy Adi for this incredible work to make it possible to use Oxygen OS on this Poco X4 Pro. I mean, it's been 3 years since the phone has launched and still the community is alive. Anyways, moving down, you can check the Android version from this tab, and obviously this is based on Android 15 with the security patch of 1st March 2025, and for the kernels, you get the stock kernel by default. And obviously you don't get any kernel issue support. Now moving further, if we talk about the home screen and its features, so you have probably noticed this app folders you get here, which looks really great. And I'll exactly show you how you can customize it yourself. Like firstly, if I add these two apps to create an app folder, you can adjust the size by swiping it along the side. So yes, that's something new I have seen for the first time. Anyways, on the left side, you get this Google Vault. And now, if I talk about the other features, so when we hold the home screen for a while, you can see that you get a bunch of features right here. So starting with the wallpapers, you get some pre-included wallpapers in the system. And if we move down, you can also check out a lot of wallpapers in their theme store. Other than that, you also get features regarding icons. So firstly, you get a couple of pre-included icon packs by default, which you can apply as per your choice. And you also get this action system color, which is exactly same as the themed icons. So if you were wondering about it, so yes, it's there, and you can also customize the app icon size and name from here. And if you are thinking about more icon packs, so yes, you also get a lot of other icon packs in the theme store which are paid, but you can also access the free trials if you are wondering to try them. Anyways, you can also add app widgets, and if you want to adjust the screen and app grid size, so this option allows you to do that. And moving further, you also get a lot of transition effects and the animation looks really polished. Now when we click on this more option, another tab opens with a bunch of other features. Like firstly, you can customize the home screen, whether you want to keep the app drawer and moving back. Also get an option to customize the swipe down feature for the home screen, whether you want to keep the QS panel or the global search. And in my case, I try to keep it simple by selecting the QS panel. And by the way, you also get this advanced visual effects feature, on in simple terms blur effects, which adds blurs on various parts of the system UI including the app drawer and QS panel. So I keep it enabled for better visuals. Now when you move down, you get this section for lock screen, wake up and tap features, but let me tell you, none of the features seems to work. I mean, I have enabled them and also tried restarting my phone hoping that they might work, but unfortunately, it doesn't seem to work. So this is a bug you are going to encounter if you are thinking of flashing this build. Other than that, you also get this section for recent menu where you can customize the recent menu style. Like currently, I have set it on this tagged style, which definitely looks great. And for the animations, so yes, it's polished, and you can also check the RAM information from here. Moving ahead, you get this tab for gestures where you can customize the gesture sensitivity. And by the way, if you are thinking about circle to search, so yes, it works absolutely fine without any problem. Now, if I talk about the quick settings or the control center, so you get this kind of QoS panel, I mean the typical OxygenOS panel, like controlling the Bluetooth and Wi-Fi from here, and you can also adjust the brightness from these tiles, and you get the other tiles right below them. And for editing them, then yes, you can simply tap on this edit tiles option from here so as to add the changes. Now when you click on this customize quick settings option, you get this two tiles, the split and the classic. Like currently I have set it on classic styles that pop up the notification below the QoS panel, but for the split style you get this new media player. And when you swipe on the left side, it opens the notification panel which shows the notifications, but I use the classic style for a clean and easy experience. Anyways, you can also customize the tile shapes from this option, like you get multiple shapes. So yes, that's it for the QoS panel. Okay, so now if we talk about the pre-installed apps, so you get the OnePlus dialer, and other than that, you also get the stock OnePlus system apps. So starting with the theme store, so you get themes, multiple font styles and wallpapers. And while we are talking about it, if you look upon the lock screen, so you get this depth effect in the wallpapers like we saw in HyperOS, which is again inspired from iOS. Anyways, let me tell you how it works. So firstly, when we select any wallpaper, it detects the depth layer automatically, and we can drag the wallpaper along the screen to adjust the depth effect. And when you tap on this clock, you get a couple of clock styles, and even you can adjust the font along with its size. Moving back, if we tap on this depth button, it turns on and off the depth effect. And for the styles, so you get a couple of wallpaper effects right here, and you can also adjust the blurs. So yes, that's it for the wallpaper customizations. So yes, moving back to the pre-installed app, so you get the OnePlus Photos app, and you get a ton of features for editing your photos, like adding filters, adding text, and you also get this magic eraser feature. But anyways, for the other apps, so you get this phone manager to manage your system, like storage controls, scanning viruses. And when you move down, you also get this app lock and app clone features. So if you were worried about privacy, this is a good news for you. Now if we talk about the features and customizations, so when we open the settings app and look upon the connection features, so you can set VPN and private DNS from here. And moving down, when we open the wallpapers and styles tab, you get a couple of customizations right here, like multiple theme presets for your home screen and wallpapers. And moving down, if we look upon the always on display tab, you get a couple of themes for your always on display, but the sad thing is, the always on display is broken. Yes, when you enable it, it turns for about 4 to 5 seconds, and after that the screen just turns off. I mean, I have tried multiple times but still it doesn't fix it. So yes, this is a major bug if you were excited for it, but what can we say now? Now talking about the display features, so firstly you get some color modes for your display, and other than that you also get some enhancement features like adaptive tone, which enhances the image as per the screen color temperature. And moving down, you also get this tab called video enhancement engine with multiple features like image sharpener, video color boost for better colors while watching the movies. And you also get this bright HDR mode, which might not work technically because Poco X4 Pro doesn't support HDR playback. But anyways, if we look upon the sound and vibration settings, so you get this basic sound and vibration features right here. But other than that, if you check for the sound effects, so Dolby Atmos is here, but it doesn't work. I mean, I didn't found any change after turning it on and off, so that might be an issue if you were wondering about it. Now if we look upon the security and privacy settings, so firstly talking about the fingerprint and face lock. So fingerprint works, but you need to turn on the display to make it work. Like if I turn off the screen and keep tapping my fingers, nothing happens. But once I turn on the screen and tap my fingers, it opens. And for the face lock, so it's dead right now. I mean, I tried adding the face model, but it doesn't let me add it. So yep, these are some bugs you are about to encounter regarding both fingerprint and face lock. Talking about the battery features, so firstly when you open the battery health tab, you can check the maximum capacity right here. And other than that, you also get features like smart charging and charging limit for better battery health in long term. So yes, these were the primary features you get in this OxygenOS 15. And now let's talk about the most interesting part, the performance and gaming. So starting with the AnTuTu score, so it scored 463k, which is amazing. I mean, it's been a long time since I saw a ROM with that much score, and I'm really surprised. Even for the CPU throttle test, the CPU throttled to 87% of its max performance with a max dip score of 185k under 20 threads. But if we talk about the real life gaming performance, so firstly in PUBG Mobile or BGMI, you get up to ultra extreme settings unlocked. But obviously, I tested the gaming performance under smooth plus extreme settings for better consistency. And for the results, so for TDM matches, I got about 58 to 60 FPS consistently, which is a great number. And even for classic matches, you can consider 55 to 60 FPS even in longer sessions. And by the way, for the battery backup, so I got an average battery backup of 7 to 8 hours in heavy usage. So yes, the battery backup this ROM delivers is also great. Now, if you want to know the integrity status, so as of now, it only passes basic integrity, which means that you might not be able to use some banking applications, including Google Pay. But don't worry, I have already made a video regarding fixing it, so make sure to check it out from the I button. Now, if I share my conclusions, so if you are okay with the bugs I mentioned in the video, then you should definitely give this ROM a try. I mean, you are getting to use Oxygen OS on a Poco phone and the animations are really smooth. I mean, Oxygen OS is known for its animations and polished UI. So yes, the performance is solid, the battery backup is surprisingly good, and overall, it's a great experience, and I have mentioned all the links and flashing guide in the description. So if you are willing to try this ROM, make sure to check it out. And I hope that the bugs might get fixed in the future updates. So anyways, I end this video here. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button right now for the latest updates. So goodbye and take care.